Professor Jay Garfield, who's a professor of Madhyamaka Buddhism, Tibetan Buddhism, he said once that fish are the wrong people to ask about water. And we are the wrong people to ask about awareness, because just like fish are continuously immersed in water, and so they lose awareness of water, we are continuously immersed in awareness, and hence we lose awareness of awareness. So it takes an effort to regain awareness of awareness, though it's always there. Like a fish in water, we are always in awareness. We are awareness according to Advaita Vedanta, but to regain awareness of awareness takes a little effort. So we will do this. What we will do is that first we will empty out the contents of awareness. We'll bring in actual silence and then note the awareness itself, which we are. Note that we are awareness, that we will see. That awareness is always there, that we will see. And then come back into the world of noise and realize the awareness is there all the time. So that's what we will do now. When we are comfortable, we can sit silently, still. It helps if you sit straight, not rigid. And when we are comfortable, we can gently close our eyes, sitting still, breathing normally, let go of any kind of tightness or tension in the body. Relax the body. Bring attention to the breath. Bring attention to the breath at the nostrils. The sensation of the breath going in, don't force the breath. If it is short breath, let it be short breath. If it is a long breath, let it be long breath. At the nose, sensation of the breath going in and going out. For a minute or two, let us just follow the breath going in and going out. It may help if you like. You can count when the breath comes in, count one. When the breath starts to go out, count two. Again, when the breath comes in, count three. Do this up to 10. Breathing normally, relaxed. Now gently become aware of the sounds in the room, outside the room. Note the arising of the sounds, various sounds. Don't follow the sounds, just note the sounds. Note how they arise in your awareness. Play around in your awareness and disappear. Distant sounds, nearby sounds. Here we are sitting, we can hear the sounds of children playing in a nearby playground. Now the tendency of the mind is, when it hears the sound, it will imagine the children playing, but don't do that. Just focus on the sound itself. Notice the sound of the children's voices arises in awareness. It is presented to awareness. It arises in awareness and it disappears in awareness. Awareness was there before the sound. Awareness is there during the sound and after the sound. Awareness continues. Sounds come and go. Breathing normally, relaxed. Notice it is to this awareness that all various kinds of sound come. It is to this awareness that forms arise when our eyes are open, we see. Same awareness illumines our seeing. Same awareness illumines our taste and our touch. Same awareness illumines smell and taste and touch and sound and form. The activities of the five senses are various, but the awareness is the same. Not only in sensing, but in all action. When I walk, when I talk, when I grasp things, in all actions, when I eat, same awareness continues. All the actions arise in awareness, play around in awareness, disappear back into awareness. The thoughts, memories, ego, desire, enjoyment, pain, all of them arise in awareness, play around in awareness, and disappear back into awareness to be replaced by other thoughts, other desires, other enjoyment and other suffering. Indeed, my entire waking, same awareness. And when the waking world disappears and the dream world comes, the various worlds of our dream, same awareness continues. And when everything disappears into darkness of deep sleep, same awareness continues. And when we wake up again, same awareness continues. Our waking, the waker and the waker's world, the dreamer and the dreamer's world, dream world, and the deep sleeper and the deep sleep world all appear and disappear in the same awareness. Relaxed, breathing normally. Notice it is the same awareness which illumines happiness and misery. They come and go. I am the same. Through the various stages of life, from babyhood to childhood to teenage, youth and middle age and old age, it has been the same awareness, only the contents of awareness have changed. I am awareness. When the contents of awareness are expelled, the mind is calm, the senses are shut down, the body is still. Awareness illumines the restful, peaceful mind. When the mind is busy, senses are fully active, it is still the same awareness which illumines the active mind and senses. I am awareness. In deep meditation, where nothing is experienced, that witness of that nothing is also awareness. When everything is quiet, I do not see anything, hear, smell, taste, touch anything. I do not think of anything, I do not remember anything. I do not desire anything nor hate anything. I do not even think I. just still, that is illumined by the same awareness, that stillness. And when I do think, when the world is there and I am active, working, talking, it is the same awareness which makes it all possible. Awareness is constant. Relaxed. A little while later, we will open our eyes and the world will appear before us. Our bodies will be experienced again. The mind will appear with its thoughts and theories. All of those will appear in awareness. And we will note that there is no transition between meditation practice and life. So-called meditation practice smoothly flows into life. What we are practicing now, when we open our eyes, we will see the same thing is there, same awareness. I will chant Om 3 times and then we will gently open our eyes. Look down at first at your own lap, don't look up immediately, and then slowly look up. Om. 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 Gently open your eyes, looking down. And slowly let us look up. Notice it is the same awareness. The margin, the border between meditation and life should be erased. What we find in deep and peaceful and successful meditation, the same thing is continuously available to us with eyes open. The utter luminous silence, the stillness, the glowingness which was there in deep silence is still here. And that is what is the witness of this entire world. Notice that awareness is free of problems. Our nature as awareness is free of problems. Old age comes to the body. Disease comes to the body and prana. Hunger and thirst come to the prana. Depression, unhappiness, restlessness come to the mind. Ignorance comes to the intellect. But none of these, old age, disease, death, ever come to awareness. Hunger, thirst, they don't come to awareness. Awareness illumines them, but they don't belong to awareness. Depression, unhappiness, misery, they don't belong to awareness. Awareness illumines them when they arise in the mind. And awareness illumines their absence also. Awareness is ever the same. When we realize this, we'll see at the deepest level, this nature of ours as awareness is problem-free. It's free of fear, it's free of wanting, it's free of grasping, free of negativity and hatred. And that's already done, it's already there, already accomplished. You don't have to change anything there. You cannot change anything there. It's a question of recognizing it and manifesting it in our day-to-day lives. And this is the ultimate nature of silence, which is there not only in silence, but also there when there is apparently noise. This silence underlies all the noise of samsara, of all the noise of life. Thank you. Namaskar.